I'm Kim Molo, fashion designer and interviewer. Today I had the honor of styling and designing a few outfits for these boys sitting next to me. They're not just regular boys, they are artists from Leeds, and yeah, let's just go around. Tell me a bit about you.
I'm Knight is IOGB Records, that's the label CEO, Leeds Finest.
Another Leeds Finest, Loz, IOGB Records.
I'm the only silver that never wants to turn gold, IOGB, baby.
That we will leave all the details at the end of this interview, and you guys can just go ahead and follow them. Today we're going to be speaking about something juicy. We're going to be talking about the music industry, about how these men be acting, how they treat and pick up girls. Are they scandalous? Or how do you guys feel like it is now, 2020? How are the girls acting when it comes to you guys saying, I'm an artist?
Everything goes, man. Anything goes.
Yeah,
for real.
It's that easy.
Yeah, for real,
They're still throwing panties at you guys.
I don't know about panties yet, but panties on the floor. Nah, seriously though, like, obviously, a female respects a man with value in it, so... Obviously, when you boss up as an individual, especially in the entertainment thing, not saying that I'm anywhere up there, I'm just, you know what I mean? But you'd be surprised, for real.
But value and sex is not really the same as love. So would you guys say that when you are artists, you don't really seek love, you kind of just seek more the flesh, Loz?
No. This is where people get it twisted and think, artists are human beings. Of course artists want love, but when you're in that industry, girls don't want to love you, they don't care about you for you, they want to know you because you're a rapper, so you take it on that value, so it's just sex.
You see them videos where the man sees the girl and he's like, yo, what's up, man, I'm trying to chat to you. She's like, I ain't got time, yeah. and then he you know when he just hits the key on a big Lamborghini truck and she's turning around. She's like, I got time now.
So basically, the minute she sees you guys and she doesn't know you guys are artists, but then she hears, wait, he's an artist, she becomes more available to it. She's ready to throw herself at you guys.
Once you're in the position of a rapper, not just any rapper or artist, you obviously have to be a good artist, because everybody's an artist nowadays. It's just if you've got the quality of one, you know what I'm saying? And I feel like females, once you get up there, sort of thing, it's like, not even up there, you could be even where we are. They turn to be like opportunists. So if they could get an opportunity wherever, they'll take it. With males, I think.
Let me just add on to that real quick as well, yeah? Because it comes down to image. When you're a rapper, a lot of people, you know, got the chains and got the that and the this and that. But when women really get to know you, and realise you're real and that's how it actually is, that's how your lifestyle is, I feel like that's when on it. But when you're just a guy who's rapping, just trying, I think they can see through that. But all comes down to image.
So it basically comes down to actually seeing through her games as well as you guys be playing a lot of games. I'm not saying specifically you, but most men in the industry. Okay, you don't play any games. You said that really quick. So, no, but that's cool because that's what we want to know. And I know from women especially, they pretend that they really want love. Wait. Whoa. We did that the last time. What? Like, I'm not skipping
can I,
you.
Can I put this into perspective?
Yeah, you can, definitely.
A man, I could see a woman in Tesco's. Mm-hmm. I'm a real, like, just down-to-earth guy, innit? Right. I can see a woman in Tesco's and see the value in her.
Okay.
But a woman can see a man in Tesco's and just walk straight past him, and that hits the nail on the head.
Yeah.
She ain't got time for no guy in Tesco's. Not saying every girl, but what's a woman trying to get to know a man? That's, you know what I mean.
Yeah.
She wants to know him when he's P. Diddy or when he's
But that's not all women. I get that that is some women, but that is not okay, most women. But don't you guys think it's because most men have been used to getting it quite easy because you guys have allowed to just go on with one girl and another girl and another girl and another girl. So you guys got to set a standard somehow. No? So you guys don't swing around?
So
you guys actually say 2020 girls are actually doing the most. They're doing the most. Elaborate that, doing the most. Like, what is it that girls really do that is the most? And why don't you guys call them out when they do it? Some of y'all will still go through the ex part with them.
Up until 2020, women have always wanted to be equal as men, but as we know, we're not equal, but women have always wanted to be equal, and one thing they've wanted to be equal with is sex.
Okay.
The reason why women lie is because they get judged, but they, like, a woman is gonna do what a woman wants to do regardless. Whether she's got a man, whether she's single, she's gonna do what she wants to do.
Not all women are gonna.
Nah. I'm not generalizing, but I'm saying most.
I'm saying most.
There are exceptions, but I'm saying most. But saying that to say, 2020 now, like, the representation of women, especially on social media, is get how you live, baby. We're out here, we're wild, hot girl summer, hot girl winter, hot girl winter. You know what I mean?
Which takes me back to
I've heard a girl say that it's hot girl winter right now.
Basically, what Knight has said, like, I feel like me trying to put myself into a woman's shoes, I feel like women think like men have it all, they can have the cake and eat it.
Right.
But what I'm saying is, I feel like because women think that, they're thinking, I'm going to do whatever, I'm going to go mad and be with 10, 20, 30, because men are, and it's all right, I'll drink as much as man, I'll do whatever, but we're not equal like that.
No.
That's what Nighties were saying. And not all men are like that either. There's people that are rappers that are in relationships that from before they get big with that ride or die girl, and now they're big and they're still with that ride or die girl.
Kevin Gates.
It is what it is, baby.
Nah, no cap though, man. It really is what it is. When I meet these women, I take it on face value and think to myself, I can't even get in my feelings and think, wow, I'm going to wife for her because I know really she's for the streets. So it is what it is.
Because I think I speak for the women that are more like of old school. Most women nowadays don't even know how to cook, like basic things. They don't even know how to clean. So if we still fool around as men, some, not you guys, if we still fool around with those type of women, we are kind of like giving them a pass. If we are to look at the music industry too, most women are naked. It's all about what you can show, tassels on your tetes and whatnot. Exactly. I mean, it's all about what you can show doing the most. You don't really leave that much to the imagination. So why don't guys just speak upon that? Because most guys do still go out and tap that girl. Facts.
Yeah, she's gonna get tackled.
Man on man.
She's gonna get tackled.
But how are you gonna be able to get that good love if you are still looking around in the same places?
I'm not looking. They're just there, and I'm a man, they're attractive, I'm going to get with them, but I'm not taking them seriously.
Okay.
There's a difference in it. But I'm looking for that value, you know what I'm saying? But they're hard to come across, but when they do come, I take them seriously.
It's not even looking for that value. She has got to conduct herself accordingly.
100%, I agree.
Me,
I can
smell the real from the fake.
Yeah.
I can smell when a female's doing too much,
mm-hmm.
whether a female's just feeling me because
she's
whatever, she's got this idea in her head. But let me tell you this, yeah, if you're a woman that you've got morals and all of that, you will always come from the perspective of, when I'm talking about females, y'all gonna be on your guard, like, nah, 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 not all females and rare, rare. But let me tell you this, man and man have been around a lot of females, and every single day we get proved right, as these, most of these girls are for the streets.
Let me just jump.
Real talk.
To go off that as well, it's true, I'm 29, like, all the lies and all that kind of stuff, I've heard a million times and I can see through it. So you can just tell the real from the fake, you know, who to just take seriously and who's just...
And females don't move off of... Females don't set an example from the actions. Yeah. They say one thing...
What females say...
Say the one thing and do the total opposite.
What females say and what females actually do are two completely different things. They can tell you, oh, I feel like this and you should do this and do that and I like this, but the actions is doing the total opposite of what they're saying they want you to do and how they feel about whatever the situation is.
You see a man like me, yeah, growing up with no dad, I'm not just speaking for my mum, I'm speaking for mums in general. Mums will never explain the game to their son of what females are like. They will tell you a lie. They'll tell you that you'll go to your mum and say, yo, this girl, man, like, I'm in love with her. And she's just like, she's just playing games with me. You get me? She's got me all, I just don't know what to do. And you know what the mum or what a woman would tell you? You got to try harder. You've got to just show her more attention. You've got to just, but when I showed her more attention and I tried harder, she didn't want not to do with me, but. She was at Jerome's yard. she was at Lozzy's yard the night before, getting her back blown out. You get me?
And to go off that, when I've been nice, I'm going out of my way to treat a woman how my mum's taught me how to treat a woman. Yeah. They're at Nighty's house. I'm not. What?
Okay, to be honest, because I know for the fact, like, my girls, we be having these conversations and most of them would never move the way that most women move out here. But that's also the influence of, if you don't value yourself, if you don't respect yourself, a man is going to see through that bullshit straight quick. But a man will also play a woman for way longer time. Like, first of all, a woman will never be able to have one night stand. If she falls in love with the ick, she's in love with the man without really admitting to it. And she will keep coming back to the same guy over and over again, pretending.
You know who that guy is? It's her ex. That's who the guy is. Or it might not be her ex, but it's just some guy, yeah, who's not emotionally involved with her, but just dicks her down right. Yeah, don't give a fuck about her, treats her like shit, and she'll still go, because that's in a woman's nature. That's in a woman's nature.
That is in a woman's nature, IOGB, baby. Nah, what Nat is saying is really true, is flowing and glowing, is making me flow even more. What he's saying is 100% true, and I've seen it with my own eyes. I've been that guy that the girls come down to because I'm getting in them guts. I'm breaking her back.
But
she's telling me about how she's got a man.
Yeah.
She's telling me how she's going to get married soon.
Can I tell you the flip of the coin, though?
And I don't even care.
We've been on the other perspective because we're good brothers. I just want one girl that's down for me to the end. Yeah. But listen, yeah, when shit hits the fan and you're low, and you turn around, she's with her next man, telling him this. One sec, she's telling him the same thing what she told me, yeah. But yeah, if you was real and you loved like that, you know what I'm saying? Dick to dick, man.
When you meet a woman and you're up and you're showing her the better things in life and you're bossing her up and you're showing her just how to conduct yourself, then things go left and you're not sitting on that money no more, or you might catch a case, or you might lose your house, you're not driving no more, you might get banned, you're not driving no more, all these kind of things. These girls are out, they're not holding you down saying, oh, I'll pick you up, I'm driving. You know what I'm saying? Move on to the next.
Say something last, so let's just you like round it out. Like, what is it that women gotta improve? Like, how can we, not we, no, I'm good, but most women out here, what is it really like they gotta make changes in? Because most women want love, facts, they want a man they can settle down with, grow old with. They don't know what.
For a lot of these girls, I'm gonna be honest, it's too late. For a lot of these, it's too late for a lot of these women.
It's too late though, like legit. Because you are 29, I'm 31, so I'm just saying.
For me, it's not too late. But for these other women out here, I feel like it's, yeah, because like, who wants to really want a wife here, a girl that's just got a bad CV?
And that's when they're coming back to you.
Then that's when they're, like, obviously. Like, obviously, it is what it is, and this is what I'm saying. I'm not in my feelings. If you want to be with 100 men, that's on you. But don't expect to get wifed either. And that's it. Some might get not by real people that can, you know what I'm saying? But that's what I would say for the females. Just hold yourself down and conduct yourself properly if you, with some respect, you know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, you're someone's daughter. Lead by your actions, and that's me. But for a lot of these females, it's too late.
Just to settle on that note, yeah, I'm looking at all you females in the eyes right now. Yeah. You're all having a conversation right now with all of your friends. Yeah. And the conversation goes like this. This guy don't give a fuck about me, and rare, and then and there, but I'm confused. I love him. I wanna go back to him. And then you're gonna tell that friend. Don't go back to him. Mm-hmm. And then she's gonna come off the phone to you and say, yeah, you're right. She's gonna ring her next friend and tell her the same story. That same friend's gonna tell her, don't go back to that man. And they're gonna go around the whole tribe, and they're still gonna go back to that man and get the back blown out. And then they're gonna sit in the seat and talk to a man like me and say that, oh, you know, not all women are like this, and we just want this, and you guys just rare. And then I'm thinking, yeah, all sounds good, but judging by your actions, it really don't make it's not, something's not adding up right now. You feel me? But there are decent girls out there who keep themselves to themselves. Yeah. They hustle hard, they get the bag, they've got morals, they've got respect. And you know why they got morals and respect? Probably because a mum has morals and respect. And you know what I mean? Each one teach one, innit? But I'll let Tova round this up, because he's the girl, them sugar. You see the nose ring.
Pretty bite. What Loz was saying as well, it is too late for some girls, man. Like, bruv, you can't come do shakara with John and Terry and then come around here and try to say to me, you're the only one. I don't want to be the only one. Get out of here, man. Just take it easy, baby.
Yeah, like a lot of these girls will tell you, oh, I've never done this before. You're the first one I've ever done this with. And I'm like, yeah, cause.
Sex in 10 months.
Yeah.
But we're not asking the questions, though, because we're just thinking, really, I'm just trying to beat, because I don't know you right now. You and your friend are at my yard right now, and your friend is busting it open for my friend right now. She's never met him before, but yet you're telling me that your mate is a good mate, yeah? And she hadn't had sex in 10 months, but she's getting her back blown out. Listen, by Loz.
On that note, you know what, like, oh, I feel a bit ashamed for half of these women who are actually out there acting like this. That's why we're doing this, because we need to hear the real truth. I mean, most of y'all women really need to wake up and hear the real truth. Do better and do good for yourself. Like, put yourself first and know that if you're willing to bend yourself over for a man that's not even willing to love and respect you, girl, bye. I mean, learn how to cook, learn how to wash the dishes, learn how to actually take care of yourself, pay your own rent, do some of that. On that note, thank you guys. We will continue doing this. Thank you, boys, for doing this with me.
No problem.
Yeah, respect. Thanks, peace.
IOGB, baby.